point of view when I had a dream school. Ano kaya yon? Would it have dinosaurs like experiments? Little things that become big.
Something has happened that has changed the way we live, work, play, and even learn in the whole world at the same time.
Tama, teacher. A small thing. Napakaliit. has caused the world to turn upside down. It's almost invisible, like these microorganisms.
Ang programang ito ay nagsimula dahil sa pandemic para sabay-sabay tayong lahat malinawan tungkol sa connection ng maraming mga bagay sa ating buhay.
Welcome back to Mindy School Online!
I'm Mind Mover Abby.
And I'm Mind Mover Aaron. We are the resident biologists of the Mind Museum. We'll be your companions in this season's nature adventures about living things and the environment.
In this season, we'll discover what makes something alive, what forms life takes, and what lets organisms thrive. Tutukasin natin ang sagot sa mga tanong na, how many forms of life are there? How do our bodies work? And how are living things connected to the world? Pag-uusapan din natin how we could better take care of ourselves and the earth we share with many other organisms.
By the art cart, we'll get up close and personal with budding Filipino artists who create art inspired by nature. We'll hear their stories and peek into their creative processes. Together, let's discover the marvels and ingenuity of these local artists and be inspired by Filipino talent. Kilalanin natin ang galing Pinoy.
Let us nurture your minds as we connect the life sciences
and art inspired by nature. Kita-kits tayo dito sa Mind School Online,
where learning leads to a better normal.
What if you and I had a dream school? Ano kaya yon? Would it have dinosaurs like experiments? Little things that become big. What if we can suddenly see invisible things? Would it have a giant heart or a big, big brain? Or flies into outer space?
Magandang hapon sa inyong lahat and welcome to a very special edition of Mind at Home. So I'm Mind Mover Abby. I'm one of the resident scientists at the Mind Museum.
And I'm Mind Mover Aaron. I'm one of the resident scientists also of the Mind Museum.
Oh my God, it's so good to see you again, Aaron. We haven't seen each other for quite some time.
Oh, diba? Mag-iisang buwan na. Welcome back, everyone.
Yes, hello. So last month, we actually celebrated something special. So we had our Kahoot for TMM's birthday celebration. And naman, it's April 22. What are we celebrating, Aaron?
Today, we're again celebrating a very special day kasi today is actually Earth Day. Alam mo, Abby, every day naman actually is Earth Day. But today is the day that we celebrate and remember to do our part to care for the planet we call home. Pero dito sa museum, hindi lang isang araw natin siya i-celebrate. We actually have 3 days worth of free activities for everyone. So stay tuned to this live stream, to the live chat, at para makita ninyo kung ano-ano yung 3 days na yun.
Oh my God, that sounds very exciting. So while you're at it, why don't you follow us at the Mind Museum, at BGC Art Center, at Mind School, and subscribe to the Mind School YouTube channel.
So while you're at it, if you're gonna post or tweet something about our activities this Earth Day weekend, post about your experience and use the hashtags EarthDay2021, Mind@Home, The Mind Museum, MindSchool, BGC Art Center, Inspired Learning, and Mind@Home.
Yan. So now, ano nga ba ang ginagawa natin dito, Aaron? Ano ang gagawin natin this Kahoot quiz?
Well, today, meron na naman tayong isang edition ng ating Mind at Home online Kahoot quiz game. So tingnan nga natin sa live chat, meron na ba ditong naka-attend ng ating TMM at 9 birthday Kahoot live stream last month? Kung meron na, sigurado ko you already have an idea kung ano yung mangyayari today. But to those who are joining us only for the first time, so welcome! Welcome to the Mind School YouTube channel and welcome to our very special Mind at Home online Kahoot quiz game. So the mechanics of this game for this afternoon will be as follows. Number one, this Kahoot quiz show is open to the public. So anyone with a phone and an internet connection can join.
So if you haven't joined yet and you're still on our live, players must actually log on to www.kahoot.it or install the Kahoot app. So you still have time to install it. And you can use your smartphone or your laptops to enter the game pin. So the game pin is actually displayed on our screens right now. It's 4256167.
Okay, so the Kahoot pin, the URL and the Kahoot pin are down below. And off to the other side, you will find there a registration link. So since we are using anonymized name, so it's not your actual name on the Kahoot system. So we need you to register at bit.ly/tmmquiz. So you can find that at the lower right side. So it's bit.ly/tmmquiz. It has to be all caps, okay? So there we will be getting your real name and your contact information so that kung kayo ang mananalo this afternoon, we can contact you on how to deliver your prizes.
All right. So remember to register because players who fail to register at the link provided are actually disqualified from receiving prizes, if any. So don't wait this opportunity if you actually win. Sana na-send nyo na ang inyong mga details sa ating registration para bigay namin sa inyo ang inyong mga prize.
Okay, and it's important to remember that the winners must nominate a Metro Manila address for the delivery of prizes. Otherwise, so kung kunyari po kayo nasa probinsya while you're joining us this afternoon, the winner shall either shoulder the delivery fee to locations outside of Metro Manila or nominate a Metro Manila address. So kung meron kayong kamag-anak dito sa Metro Manila, pwedeng doon namin sila ipa-deliver and then sa kanyo ipa-deliver ulit to your provinces outside Metro Manila. So Abby, ano ba kaya, ano ang prizes natin this afternoon?
My God, Aaron, ang dami nating prizes this afternoon. So just like our Kahoot quiz last time, winners of this Kahoot quiz game will also be receiving items from the Mind Museum. So Aaron, okay. Ano yung fifth and fourth place na prizes?
Okay, so fifth and fourth. So lima ang mananalo this afternoon, no, Abby? Okay, so yes. For our fifth and fourth prizes, you will win the Mind Museum designed face masks. Okay, so check out our space-themed reusable face masks made from neoprene and spandex layers. Each mask comes with a slit so you can insert your own filter. They come in three designs, museum icons, I need space, and an astronaut, available in both adult and kid sizes. So yun yung for our fifth and fourth prizes. Ano naman yung makukuha ng ating third and second placers, Abby?
God, exciting then prizes for third and second place. So the third and second place winners will actually be receiving season passes to our Minus School Online Season 2. So Minus School Online is your online subscription to connected learning through K-12 aligned video lessons and resources. So for its second season, we'll actually be learning about life through the lens of biology. And you have your hosts, Mind Movers Aaron Espinosa and Abigail Napeñas.
Uy, Aaron, nandito rin pala
tayo sa Minus School Season 2, no?
Oo. Oh, marami kami ginagawa, di ba? Nakakapagod din po mag-host. Hindi, joke lang. Siyempre, masaya naman na nakasama natin yung ating fans and patrons of the Mind Museum. So don't forget to visit mindschoolph.org for more details. Mamaya-maya sa live stream natin, pag-uusapan din natin ulit ang Mind School Online. Okay, so for our first prize, so the first prize will receive a very special book. It's the What is Nature Augmented Reality book. Since a museum visit is not available now, we created another reality for you so you can know what that wonder sits everywhere. Get your What is Nature Everything is book at mindschoolph.org/promos and you can also see there the other great deals and merchandise you can get from the Mind Museum.
Speaking of great deals and merchandise, meron din po mga events na ino-offer ang Mind Museum ngayon. So even though you can't visit the museum, as we said earlier, you still have a chance to have the museum experience with us. So don't miss out on our amazing shows and fun activities from two of your scheduled online workshops for you and your kids right at home. So we're actually offering the Science Staycation, both for Earth. So for Earth Explorers, we have it on May 8, 2021. From 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. So for this science staycation, we'll actually be doing climate change for kids and we'll be crafting a paper volcano and we'll also be doing creepy crawly cupcakes. So we'll be learning about layers of the soil through this activity. So if you want your kids to join, please check out our science staycation for Earth explorers.
And we also have another science vacation, the Space Scout. So that will be on the same day, May 8, 2021, from 2 to 3:30 p.m. So there you'll be having Stargazing 101. So you'll learn how to read the stars and see or label some major constellations. You'll also build a star lamp from the Sky Above Science Wonder Kit. And we'll also be learning the phases of the moon through cookies. Okay, so go to mindschoolph.org/sciencevacation or email us at programs@themindmuseum.org to register. Enjoy the fun and learning as well. Get your very own science kits delivered to your home and gain access to those shows and activities that we've prepared for you. Registration is extended until tomorrow, April 23.
All right, so you have until tomorrow to join our science staycation, and we promise you that you and your kids will have a lot of fun here. So together, let's make science learning accessible for all. So you can visit us at www.themindmuseum.org/donate. So your purchase or donations will actually support our foundation's bigger mission of championing science and art learning for a better world and to bring education to as many families, including kids and students who don't actually have access to online learning.
Tama ka dyan, Abby. Okay, so ngayon sa Kahoot Quiz game natin, we already have 42 participants so far. Okay, so let's just go back to the mechanics para sa mga kakapasok lang dito sa ating live stream can also join in on the fun. So once again, welcome everyone to the very special Earth Day Mind at Home online Kahoot Quiz game. So this Kahoot Quiz show is open to the public. Just access it on your phone, your laptop, your tablet, your smartphone, and you can also join us here this afternoon.
Okay.
Okay, so remember to log on at kahoot.it and or install the Kahoot app on your smartphone and use the game pin that you can find down below. So it's 4256167. So once you generate your unique Kahoot game name, remember to register at bit.ly/TMMQuiz. It's capital TMMQUIZ so that we know who you actually are and we'll get your contact information. So if you win your prizes, pwede namin silang ipadala kung nasan kayo sa Metro Manila. If you fail to register at the link provided, you will be disqualified from receiving those prizes. Kasi hindi namin alam kung sino kayo. Kasi anonymized animals yung names natin. And then for winners inside Metro Manila, so we can handle the delivery of prizes for you. Otherwise, if you live outside of Metro Manila, either nominate a Metro Manila address ng kamag-anak nyo and then we'll have it delivered there. Or you can shoulder the delivery fees to locations outside of Metro Manila. Okay, so Abby, meron na tayong 51 participants na naka-ready na sumali sa ating online Kahoot Quiz game this afternoon.
Wow, that's so exciting. Sige, let's just wait a bit more for more participants to come in.
Okay.
So if you have friends who would also like to join,
okay, so for those who registered at bit.ly/TMMQuiz, please remember to input your anonymized Kahoot quiz name. Okay, so para mapagtapat namin, say for example, we see here a bold penguin. So sino kaya yan si bold penguin? So through the link bit.ly/TMMQuiz, we'll know kung sino kayo and kung saan namin kayo kukontakin. So for those who baka nakalimutan yun to add your anonymized Kahoot name, you can just send another registration form. Another registration. Okay, so that would be your Kahoot nickname. So kung ano yung lumabas na name when you generated it sa ating magic roulette, please input it at bit.ly/TMMQuiz. Kung nakalimutan nyo siyang ilagay kanina, just send another submission through the same form. Okay, so meron na tayong 58 participants, Abby. Ano nga ba ang pag-uusapan natin sa ating Kahoot Quiz game this afternoon?
Okay, so for today's Kahoot Quiz game, we'll actually be asking questions about Philippine biodiversity. So para dyan sa mga interested, sa mga facts about our flora and fauna here in the Philippines, and some basic earth facts since it's Earth Day, this is the game for you. So stay tuned, and it's so exciting. Na-excite na ako itanong yung mga questions dito kasi sobrang varied talaga sila.
Oo, naalala mo ba yung nangyari nung huli nating Kahoot? maraming nagulat na hindi science-related yung mga questions natin. Naalala mo ba ano yung first question natin nung huli?
Oh my God, yung first question natin, di ba? Nagtanong tayo about Blackpink and Twice. So, sino daw doon yung hindi member ng Twice?
Oo, maraming nagulat na hindi sila science-related. So, ngayon, it will be a bit more science-related. So, we'll focus on Philippine plants and animals and the state of the earth in general ngayon since Earth Day nga, di ba?
So, it's time to break out what you've learned from your science classes.
Okay, so I think we're ready to start. We already have 63 participants. Ready ka na ba, Abby? Okay, so anytime during the game, pwede kayong humabol. So, the Kahoot pin and the registration link will stay at the bottom of your live stream screen. So, kung ma-disconnect kayo or you're just joining in, you can join in at the middle of the game.
Okay. Yes.
So, ano nga ba ulit ang sistema ng...
game na to.
Oo, di ba? So, final reminder before we start, if makita nyo sa screen ninyo that it says that Kahoot is attempting to reconnect, please do not refresh the Kahoot page. Kasi Okay, so mawawala kasi yung scores ninyo kapag ni-refresh nyo yung page. So you'll go back to the start and you'll have to get another nickname tapos register again. So if it says that you cannot connect or it's trying to reconnect, do not refresh. Kusa siyang babalik sa game natin. Okay? So again, final reminder, sa Kahoot app po sasagot. Okay, so no last time, meron nagsasagot sa ating live chat. So that's also helpful dun sa mga hindi naglalaro so they can see. Okay, so yan. Kunyari, we see here si Silver Marie Brodit. Hello, so you don't have Kahoot, that will play along sa YouTube. Oo naman, it's fun for everyone. Either kahit wala kayo sa Kahoot or nandito kayo, sana may matutunan kayo sa ating questions this afternoon. Okay?
So for those na joining us.
Yes, maraming salamat. So for those na nasa Kahoot, answer through the Kahoot app, okay? So pabilisan to at pagiging tama ng score. Okay, game. Ready ka na ba, Abby?
I am so ready. Excited na ako para sa quiz show na to. And excited na rin ako para sa mga mananalo for this game. And para sa mga matututunan ng ating audience today.
Okay, so let's start our Earth Day Mind at Home Kahoot quiz game. So the first round is about Earth's wonders. Okay, so this will be general questions about the state of the Earth. So let's start with question number one. Where is most of the Earth's fresh water? O kasi sa beach, no, lahat yun maalat. Pero mayroong isang area na fresh water. Okay, so the correct answer is Antarctica. So nakatago siya actually doon sa glaciers of Antarctica. Most of the world's fresh water is frozen in the ice caps. Okay, so Antarctica accounts for 90% of the Earth's total ice volume and holds about 70% of Earth's fresh sea levels up to 200 feet. Or around 15 building stories tall if completely
Grabe,
melted.
Ang
Oo, so it's very important na we do measures to prevent those ice caps from melting. No, so like yung carbon emissions na,
so we should fun and every single day let's try to do our part for the planet.
Question number two. Oh, before question number two, ayan, si Wonder Zebra ang in the lead. Okay, yes. Let's move to question number two. The species currently living on Earth make up around blank percent of all species that have ever lived. So,
kung isipin ko, mayroon ang daming dinosaurs dati, di ba? So, like, yun pa lang, ang dami-dami na nila, but now we can't see them. So, ilang percent? Species on Earth ang buhay ngayon.
Parang lahat na nakikita natin either sobra, parang marami namang buhay, 'di ba? Pero marami na palang nawala kasi the correct answer is 1%. Okay, so siya may pinaka-konting
lang.
Oo, so siya may pinaka-konting nakakuha ng tama. So only 5 got it correctly. Lang. Yes, so only living species na nandito ngayon kasi around 99.9% of all species that have ever lived are extinct. So that's more than 5 billion species each with their own populations at some moment in time. Okay?
So wow, 5 billion species.
Oo, so kung mababawasan pa sila lalo, edi less than 1% na lang yun, di ba? Oo. Okay, so let's move to question number 3. Which of the following is the tallest tallest mountain in the country? So that's here in the Philippines. So kung meron tayong naglalaro abroad, which one is the tallest mountain in the Philippines?
Time to remember our lessons. Di ba pinapa-recite sa atin to dati nung bata tayo?
Tallest mountain is
one of the facts that we have to know.
So the correct answer is it's Mount Apo. Okay, so majority naman yung nakakuha nun.
Yes.
Okay, so Mount
Lessons.
So Mount Apo is the tallest mountain in the country at approximately 2,954 meters tall. Sierra Madre is the longest mountain range. Hindi siya yung pinakamataas. So it's 500 to 540 kilometers long. Mount Canlaon naman is the tallest in Visayas. Tapos Mount Mayon is syempre famous for its near-perfect symmetrical coaching. Okay? So tignan natin ating scoreboard. Si Wonder Zebra pa rin ang leading. Pero humahabol si Noble Newt. 7 points lang ang pagitan nila, Abby.
Grabe. Iba talaga ang labanan dito sa Kahoot, no? Ang galing ng scoring nila.
So let's move to question number 4. Which word best describes the shape of the Earth? Well,
ano nga ba ang shape ng mundo, Iron?
Isang pale blue dot, di ba? Or the blue planet. Pero yung shape niya, ano kaya shape niya, no? Okay, so time's up. The correct answer is it's an irregular ellipsoid. So yung irregular ellipsoid is a squished sphere. So the Earth, while often shown as a sphere, is actually an irregular ellipsoid. So kung meron kang sphere, pisatin mo siya ng konti, that's the shape of the Earth. So it's kind of like a sphere that got squished slightly. Tapos bumpy all over with our many mountains and volcanoes. Okay, let's move.
Hindi nila bilog ang mundo, irregular ellipsoid pala.
Oo. At nag-iba na ang nasa lead, si Noble Newt na. Natin. Remember, yung top 5 ang magkakaroon ng prizes this afternoon.
Yes.
Okay, let's go naman to question number 5. So medyo kabaligtaran naman nung kaninang question, where is the deepest point on Earth located? So hindi lang to in the Philippines, ha? On the whole Earth, where is the deepest point located on the Earth?
Ba, Aaron, kahit sa deepest point ng Earth, they have found microbial activity. So imagine mo yun, grabe na yung pressure doon. Pero meron pa rin microbes that are living there. Ang galing talaga ng mga species, no?
Oo, at yung deepest point na yan is the Marianas Trench. Okay, so the Marianas Trench is 10,984 meters deep. So almost equivalent siya ng tatlong Mount Apo na pinagpatong-patong mo, no?
Grabe.
Ganun siya kalalim. Yung Philippine Trench, it's the third deepest. Okay? Tapos both of those could be enough to cause your lungs to cave in or maging crushed from immense ocean pressure. Despite that, recently lang, merong isang Pinoy na nakababa na sa Philippine Trench. Nabalita mo ba yon, Abby?
Hindi, pero ngayon ko lang nalaman to and it's fascinating that somebody actually went down there considering how dangerous it could be. So ang galing talaga ng mga Pinoy.
Oo, di ba? Okay, let's move to question number 6. The word Earth comes from the word Erda. Where does this word originate from? So, saang language siya nang galing? Oo. Naku, alam ka ba ibang language bukod sa English at Filipino, Abby?
Ay, wala na, Aaron. Ano lang, mga Korean lang ganun. Hello?
Korean! At yung samgyupsal, ganun. Samgyupsal. Okay, so the correct answer is Anglo-Saxon.
Okay, so it comes from, wow.
So medyo kalahi ng English. So you may be familiar with the word terra, so that's Latin for land. Tapos it's often used as a synonym for earth in pop culture. Pero yung word na earth itself comes from the German English or old school Anglo-Saxon word erda, which means soil.
Oh, hey. So you learned another new fact that you can tell your friends, di ba?
Oh, di ba? Oh, erda.
Space Bobcat na ang leading.
Oo, di ba? Mainit-init ang labanan, di ba? Nag-iiba siya lagi. Okay, move tayo sa question number 7. on average, which planet is the densest in our solar system?
Ano kaya dito ang densest? So, balik-balik na naman tayo sa science classes natin para ma-recall natin kung ano nga pa ang densest.
Pinaka-siksik, di ba? So, pinaka-jam-pack ng content. So, alin dito sa apat na planeta yun? Okay, so time's up. The correct answer is Earth, yung planeta natin. Okay, so even though na mas malaki than Earth, si Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus, mas ang Earth ang pinaka-dense planet in the solar system. So kasi nga gas giants kasi yung Jupiter, Saturn, at Uranus, di ba? So parang balloon. Malaki, pwede siyang malaki pero wala masyadong laman. Hangin lang. Di ba? Okay. Oo. Ayan. So si Space Bobcat pa rin ang in the lead with 5 straight correct answers. Out of 7.
Galing naman. Kaya niyan, guys.
Oo.
Go Space Bobcat and everyone.
Question number 8. What is the largest contiguous coral reef in the Philippines? Ano yung sabihin ng contiguous, Abby?
Big word. So by contiguous, we actually mean that the reefs are touching each other doon sa coral reef na yon. In contrast to being scattered around the particular area. So ano yung sabihin ito yun?
Ito yun. Ang tamang sagot ay apple reef. Okay, so makikita mo dito actually na halos karamihan sa atin ang sinagot ay Tubataha Reef.
Okay.
So in terms of size, in terms of space, siya yung pinakamalaki at 322 square kilometers. Pero yung reefs kasi ng Tubataha are separate. So meron kang distinct reefs along those 322. So yung pinakamalaki na isang buong reef in the Philippines is Apo Reef at 34 square kilometers.
Oo, kasi dikit-dikit sila or magkakatabi sila.
Oo. Ayan, nag-iba na naman yung in the lead, si Cute Turtle. Tapos sabi dito, si Captain Dragon daw ang highest na ang tinaas in places. Umakit siya ng 20 places from kanina.
Yes, up by 20 places, Captain Dragon. Ang cute naman ng name.
Oo, di ba? Okay, question number 9. What do we call the most recent supercontinent?
Most recent supercontinent. So, yung mga nung time na magkakautikit pa silang lahat.
Oo, isang buo siyang lupa dapat. So, alin kaya, alin ang sa apat? Ang tamang supercontinent. Ayan, correct answer is Pangea. Okay. So, si Atlantica at si Gondwana, naging continents din sila before, pero they're not under the definition of a supercontinent. So, kaya si Pangea ang latest supercontinent. So, syempre, karamihan sa atin, we know Atlantis. It's, ano,
the lost city.
Oo, di ba? Okay. Okay, so let's move to the last question of our first round about the Earth's wonders. What is the coldest natural place on Earth?
Okay, so,
ano nga? Ang mga scientists, nakagawa na sila ng temperatures mas malamig pa than this sa laboratory. Pero in terms of natural coldest place, ano kaya yun dito sa apat?
So, actually, temperatures here have been recorded to be negative 93 degrees Celsius. Imagine mo yun!
Oh, you're dead kung nandiyan ka. Okay, so the correct answer is Antarctica. Okay, so it's the coldest natural place on Earth. Okay, so recap muna tayo ng scores after round one. So our top 5 placers are Cute Turtle, Space Bobcat, Lively Piranha, Focus Shark, and Funny Griffin. Okay, so that's round 1.
Biruin mo yan, natapos agad natin yung round 1. It passed by so quickly, okay, Ron?
Oo. So, kanina we mentioned na ang Earth Day celebrations ng The Mind Museum will be 3 days. So today, that's the first day, it's our Mind at Home online Kahoot quiz game. So, ano naman yung mangyayari bukas, Abby?
I'm glad you asked, Aaron. So, I'm also excited for tomorrow because tomorrow is our BGC Art Mart Online. So, tune in to hashtag BGC Art Mart Online for a special showcase of Art for the Planet. Since it's Earth Day, we're celebrating Earth Day, we will be featuring artists and their Earth-friendly arts and crafts. So, you'll be getting to, through Art Mart Online, you'll be getting to know our inspiring local artists, and you can get the chance to shop for eco-friendly pieces, upcycled art, and artworks that actually tell stories about nature and enjoy online performances. So, ang daming pakulo ng ArtMart online bukas. So, I hope that you guys stay tuned for that.
Oo, sinabi mo pa, Abby. Special offers and giveaways will also be available for those who tune into the live stream tomorrow, April 23, from 4 to 6 p.m. Manila time, posted here also via the Mind School YouTube channel. So kung makita nyo, actually naka-ready na yun. So you can click on the video and save it for later and click on the bell to get notifications kapag magsa-start na ang ArtMart Online tomorrow afternoon. Register now for a chance to win art giveaway. So go to bit.ly/BAMO giveaway. So again, that's bit.ly/BAMO giveaway. If you'd like to join us for more science and art celebrations, syempre, don't forget to like this video, click the subscribe button, and tap the notification bell so that you'd get updated content from the Mind Museum and BGC Art Center.
Yes. So again, before we start round two, just a reminder to please register sa ating links sa live chat. So if ever you do win, sana makontakt namin kayo through the registration. So don't forget, kasi ma-forfeit yung prizes nyo if you don't register. So ready na ba kayo for round two?
Mukhang ready na sila. Okay, so again ha, yung Kahoot pin is down below and the registration link is also down below. Okay, ready na tayo to start round two. Let's go, Abby.
All right. So snake plants are often called Sansevieria trifasciata. So what is its current correct scientific name? So for all the plant titos and titas out there?
Mukhang house plants ang topic ng round two. So sa ating mga plantito, plantita, lahat ng mahilig sa house plants, this is the round for you.
Yes. Ayan. So the correct answer is Dracaena trifasciata. So recently lang chinange ang name ng snake plants because in 2017, they did genetic, or the official name was established in 2017 when they found results from genetic testing that it's actually under Dracaena.
Oh, so actually, meron nga akong katabi dito sa bahay ko. Sa Dracaena trifasciata na halaman dito, no? Okay, move tayo sa question number 12.
For question number 12, so in one Juan Tamad story, he comes upon a guava tree with ripe fruits. So which of these is not a color variety of guava?
Ano ba nangyari sa kwento ng Juan Tamad, Abby? Well, tamad siya, pero ano yung kwento ng guava na to?
Yung, alam ko, dalawang version kasi yung alam ko. Yung isa, tamad siyang umakyat, kaya hinihintay na lang niya mahulo.
Oo, so nahiga na lang siya sa ilalim, di ba?
Oo. So sabi dito, the correct answer is orange. So, so hindi pa pala kayo nakakita ng orange na guava. Kasi wala pala.
Dapat magkaroon ng ganun. Oo.
So pink and red and yellow lang kung kumakain kayo ng bayabas.
Oo. Nag-iba na yung leading natin. Si Lively Pirana na.
Oh my God. Ito na naman. Gita na naman ang laban.
Oo, no? Sige, punta na tayo sa question number 13.
Okay, so what does NPK mean for gardeners? Para ulit sa mga plantito at mga plantita, dapat alam nyo kung ano ibig sabihin ng NPK.
Oo, so these are the three most essential nutrients na meron dapat ang isang halaman. So pag wala yan, agad mamamatay po siya. Okay, so meron silang kopya lagi ng?
Ayan, so the correct answer is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium.
Okay, so yan yung three most essential nutrients. Yes. Sabi dito, ang NPK daw ay nice plants kumare. Hindi yon.
Hindi po.
Wrong po, pero oo, magaganda yan. Magandang halaman yan.
Para sa mga pambati nyo rin, NPK.
Oo. Okay, punta tayo sa question number 14.
Okay, so what do you call natural fertilizer made by earthworms? So earthworms are actually our friends sa mga garden. Minsan kapag nag-gardening ka, di ba? Makakita kami mga nagsisquiggle around ng mga bulate dyan. So they're actually our friends in helping our plants.
Oh, so this is actually made from their poop, di ba?
Yes, worm poop to.
Yeah. Okay, so may special name yung worm poop na yan. It's, ano, Abby?
It's called vermicast. So, social pala ang tawag sa worm poop. So, pag-ausap niyo yung mga fellow plantito at plantita niyo, uy, alam mo, I'm using vermicast. It's worm
poop. Lang yun. Pero meron pang isang special na poop, di ba? Yung bat poop naman. So, yun naman, guano yung tawag. So, both are very beneficial to plants kasi ang daming nutrients ng vermicast tsaka guano.
Yes.
Okay, question number 15.
So, fenestrations naturally form on many monstera species. So, ano nga mga fenestrations?
Nako.
Okay, so, dito.
Basta ang alam ko, wala akong monstera kasi ang mahal niya. Pero ang ganda. Sabi, no?
Pag tinitingnan mo yung mga presyo nila, parang, ala, hindi ko pa afford to. So, in my dreams na lang and in my illustrations ang monstera. Oh. So, fenestrations are actually holes. Because fenestration actually comes from the Latin word fenestratus, meaning it's provided with openings.
Oh, so yun yung Swiss cheese plant, no? Yun yung klaseng monstera na obvious yung kanyang mga butas-butas or fenestrations. Ay, may nag-iba ba sa leaderboard? Meron.
Space bobcat.
Congrats. Ayan, nasa top 1 ka na. In the lead ka na for our What is Nature AR book. Tingnan natin after question 16.
Question 16, Syngonium podophyllum. Wow, that's a mouthful. A common ornamental plant has been found on Mount Makiling. So it is a or an blank species.
Ang hirap niyang basahin. Pero ang ganda niya pa rin tignan. Kasi meron siyang parts na mag-green, tapos merong mas white, di ba?
Oo, ang ganda ng decoration. Ang ganda niya as decoration. But it's actually an invasive species.
Oo, so hindi siya naturally found in the Philippines. So tumubo lang siya dito kasi someone from outside the country wrote it in. At depende minsan, like say for example, yung Maya natin, that's an invasive bird, pero okay lang kasi walang negative impact. Pero like sa halaman, usually kasi sila yung mas thirsty sa tubig and sa nutrients. So plant those invasive plants responsibly, siguro, no?
Yes.
Kasi maganda pa rin eh.
Very important thing to consider. Oh, so cute turtle is now in the lead.
Paiba-iba na naman yung leaderboard natin, ha? Sige, let's move to question 17.
So which of the following lists a correct order of vegetables from the lyrics of Bahay Kubo? Ayan, kanta-kanta na tayo ng Bahay Kubo for this.
Basta ang alam ko sa pinakam... patatas po. Sa French fries.
Yes, that's a great answer. Ako hindi ako makapili because I love gulay. Wow!
Yes. Oh, very healthy.
Thank you, Mom.
Ayan. So, ano ang tamang order sa apat?
Ayan, kalabasa, labanos, at mustasa. Hindi ko na po kakantahin, pero alam niyo na yan ang tamang sagot.
Oo. Basta ang alam ko, sa tuwing kinakanta ko to, nag-iiba yung order ng mga gulay.
Ay, hala!
Oo. Ayan. Si Space Bobcat na ngayon yung in the lead. Kanina pa, no? Oo, sige. Let's move.
Pag-ikot-ikot lang siya. So, butterflies are essential to the ecosystem because they act as black. So, hindi lang po sila reminder ng inyong patay na relatives.
Oo nga. So,
po siya important role in the ecosystem.
Oo. No, ala, huwag kang maingay na dyan yung ano mo. Yung ganit, lola mo, ganun. Oo, pero may iba kasi
yung pa sa color ng butterfly.
Oo. Kasi they actually act as
pollinators. So, butterflies transfer from flower to flower and they act as pollinators.
Oo. Yeah. So, since ang primary nilang pagkain ay flowers, kapag nabawasan yung mga flowers due to illegal logging or nagtatayo tayo ng maraming buildings, mawawala rin yung populations natin ng butterflies and honeybees. So, it's important to plant correct plants with flowers para sa kanila, para mag-survive din yung species nila.
So plant wisely, guys. Don't just plant wisely. Just always remember to determine which are actually good to plant in your areas. Okay? So, yun na natin sila nasa leaderboard.
Siya pa rin.
Space Bobcat and Noble Newt. So lahat, parang lahat sila nasa, nakapag-lead na at least once. So, grabe na gitgitan talagang laban dito.
Tingnan natin kung mag-iiba yung leader sa question 9.
So, the thorns of a plant are just modified black. Ano kaya?
Nako, actually, kami po, kami dalawa ni Abby, kahit parehas kami biologists, nalilito pa rin kami sa tanong na to. So, and pero ito, we double check at nahanap na namin ng
tapos. Confirm kung ano siya.
Oo, so ano siya, Abby? Modified ano ang thorns natin?
Ayan, modified leaves ang ating thorns.
Oo, so kapag nakakita kayo ng tusok-tusok na madaling matanggal, those are thorns. Kapag hindi naman sila madaling matanggal, like sa roses, those are actually prickles or modified stems. Kaya mahirap silang tanggalin kasi ang kapal ng stem. Pero ito kasi leaves, maninipis, kaya madali lang silang maputol.
Keep that in mind when you're trying to identify thorns or prickles. So, in the lead na, wow, si Nobel Newt naman ang nasa lead ulit. So,
oo, napapasapasahan na sila. Oo. Sige, tingnan natin kung sino ang magiging leader after nitong last question natin for round 2.
Alright, so what purpose or purposes does soil serve in the care and growth of plants? Nako, very important to and very basic question.
Oo, so, bukod dun sa kulay at klase ng soil, ano yung pinaka-main function ng soil as a whole, di ba?
So, okay, ano so hindi lang sa ating choices?
Oo, hindi lang sa easy. Minsan kasi, di ba, may insects dyan. Pero kasi, ano, Abby?
Sorry.
Ano yung purpose ng soil? The correct answer is?
So the correct answer is all of the above. So so it provides minerals and other nutrients which plants get, and it also acts as the anchor point of the plant.
Oh,
so sometimes,
okay.
Actually, the amount of minerals and nutrients in the soil also give off different colors.
Oo, kaya importante rin na maraming halaman kasi nga since they it works both ways. The plant anchors sa soil and the soil is kept compacted dahil doon sa roots ng halaman. So kaya nakikita nyo, usually nagla-landslide sa areas na walang halaman masyado. So important na maraming halaman sa cliff sides and especially sa mga mangrove forest natin, no, Abby?
Yes, of course. So guys, always remember we have to take care of our planet. We have to plant the right trees because it literally holds the world together.
Oh, oh. Hey, tignan natin yung leaderboard as of round 2.
So Noble Newt is now in the lead. Wow.
Congrats. Okay, so kanina we already showed to you what will happen tomorrow ang ating Earth Art for the Planet Art Mart online. So on Saturday, the third day of our Earth Day 3-day celebration, we will actually be having a Better World Cafe. So a Better World Cafe is a science and art talk for a better world. So a year in quarantine has definitely changed our spending habits as our favorite brick and mortar food places and stores have closed for an indefinite amount of time. We've turned to online stores to buy necessities and to satisfy our needs and for retail therapy. As we've spent more time at home, our consumption of utilities has also gone up. From the waste generated by takeout and delivery packaging to the additional energy we consume spending more time on our phones and our computers, to even the fuel exhausted to get our deliveries to our doorstep. How much has a year in quarantine affected our energy use and what does this mean for our planet?
So for this Better World Cafe or BWC, let's join our esteemed speakers, Dr. Jose Isagani J. Ayhanayro, Mr. JC Peralta, and Mr. Gianni Altomonte as they talk about the environmental impacts of living a year under a lockdown. So, sobrang exciting nung mga talks nila. I can't wait for you guys to participate as well. So, catch these talks live here on the Mind is Cool YouTube channel on April 24, 2021 from 2 to 4 p.m. So, if you'd like to join us for more science and art celebrations, don't forget to like this video, click the subscribe button, and tap the notification bell so you can get updated for contents from the Mind Museum and the BGC Art Center.
Tama, Abby. So, oo nga, no, mahigit isang taon na tayong under lockdown. So, gano'n nakaraming plastic, gano'n nakaraming gasolina yung na-consume nung pag-order natin online ng pagkain tsaka yung mga halaman natin, di ba? So, exciting siyang marinig. Exciting siyang marinig pero nakakatakot din na kung gano'n nakakarami yung waste nating nagawa because of a year under lockdown. Okay, so ready ka na ba, Abby, to start our third round of questions?
Yes, I am so ready.
Okay, so itong round 3 naman, we'll be talking about wild animals. Okay, so it's time to walk on your wild side and see kung gaano ka alam ninyo ang ating wild animals around the world. Okay.
Yes.
So let's start with question number 21. What is the scientific name of a tuko? Hindi yun.
Hindi ko like Aaron. Yung mga ganun sound. Nung bata ako, grabe, takot ako pag naririnig ko yun. Tapos hindi namin mahanap kung nasaan siya.
Pero alam mo, actually, hindi pa ako nakarinig ng tuko in person. Yung legit na tuko. Wala pa. Hindi ko naririnig yun.
It's just ayan, as funny as it sounds.
Oh. Okay, so the correct answer is gecko. Okay, so for our other choices, si Hermidactylus frenatus is a butiki. Yes. Si Varanus bitatawa is an arboreal monitor lizard. Si gecko is your tokay gecko or tuko. And then si tokay is not a real lizard. Hindi po tunay na scientific name yun. Okay.
Tokay is something we made up.
Okay, so tokay isn't a real lizard. It's called a lizard, but it's not. Pero it's very aggressive and should not be kept as pets. Okay?
So kung makakita man kayo ng tuko.
Tokay.
Huwag niyo pong ilagay sa bahay. Hayaan niyo po siya mag-live ng life niya.
Oo. Okay, let's move to question number 22. Huntsman spiders and ensign wasps are common home visitors. They help control the populations of which organisms?
Nako, kahit pala takot tayo sa mga gagamba at sa mga wasp, tumutulong pala sila para hindi dumami ang population ng organism na ito. Nako, nakakainis kasi itong mga organisms na to.
Kasi nga, syempre, like tayo, kumakain din naman yung mga animal na to. So, ito yung kinakain nila. Which of these? Okay, so the correct answer is roaches. Mga yippies. Okay, so
roaches pala.
Oo, so kung makita kayo ng ganitong klaseng spider, kung kaya nyo naman na hindi matakot sa kanila, hayaan nyo lang sila doon kasi pina kayo makakakita ng maraming ipis sa bahay ninyo pag nandyan sila, di ba? So nakatulong.
I actually like seeing spiders like that sa sea.
Oh my God. Pero
nila for some reason.
Pero basta sila tatalon habang naliligo tayo, okay lang yun.
Pag dumapo siya sa likod mo, dun ka na matakot.
Oo. Bakit dinadaanan lang daw nila? Baka po bagong kain sila. So, meron din kasing, syempre, like kung kumain ka na sobrang, tingnan mo kasi yung size ng ipis, di ba, compared to the spider. So, kung isang buong ipis, baka good na yun for them for 1 week. So, eventually, aabutin din nila
yun. Spiders, kasi ayaw natin lahat sa ipis.
Oo. Okay, let's move to question number 23. Agarwood is a valuable perfume item and is formed when aquilaria trees are infected by which type of organism?
Grabe, kailangan palang ma-infect ang isang organism para mag-produce ng ganito pabango or ganitong scent. So ano kaya ang nag-infect dito sa ating agarwood para magkaroon ng ganitong scent?
Oo, pero hindi porke infected, negative na agad yung impact, di ba? So like dito, nakakagawa tayo ng mabangong item. So it's infected by a type of fungus.
Yes. So, slime molds aren't actually fungi. They're protists.
Okay, so ang protists, so malalaman niyo yan pag nanood kayo ng Mind School Online Season 2, ang mga protists ay mga organism na hindi halaman, hindi hayop, at hindi rin fungi. So, yun lang yung, walang unique sa kanila. Yun lang ang definition.
An umbrella term.
Oh, sila yung not group. Not plants, not animals. Not fungi. Okay.
That doesn't make them any less special. Yes.
Uh-oh. Okay, let's move to question 24. What color is the flower of Nara trees or Pterocarpus indica?
Pero nakakit ka na ba ng puno?
Hindi ako marunong.
Try mo na ba?
Puno, Abigail. Huwag ganon.
Ano lang naman. Pasungkit-sungkit lang. Sa puno ng bayabas, ganon. Hindi ko rin kaya umakyat.
Ayan, so the correct answer is they bear yellow flowers.
Yes.
So minsan, merong ganito nung college. May malaki kaming puno na nara noon nung college. Tapos, pag umahin na hangin, parang ka nasa stairway to heaven na eksena. Kasi lumilipad-lipad yung maliliit na yellow flowers.
Feeling mo talaga nasa K-drama ka na noon.
Oo. Okay, let's move to question 25. What do we call animals that can self-regulate their body temperature?
Ano kaya to? If you watch our Mind School online and Mind School TV, malalaman nyo rin kung ano ang sagot sa tanong na to.
Oo. So self-regulation, ibig sabihin, meron silang constant body temperature. Okay, so the correct answer are the homeotherms. Yes. Okay, so ang ibig sabihin ng homeotherm, they can self-regulate. Yung ibig sabihin naman ng poikilotherm, kinukuha nila yung they cannot. So kukunin nila yung temperature kung nasan sila. Like mga snake. So kung malamig, malamig din yung ahas. Pero yung tao, kapag nasa malamig na lugar, around 37 degrees Celsius pa rin yung temperature niya.
Alright.
Okay. So in the lead pa rin, si Noble Newt pa rin. At lumalaki ang
3,000 na. Points na. Ang laki ng agwat.
Oo.
Thanks,
okay.
Marantong Noble Newt sa science.
Oo, di ba? Okay, let's move to question 26. Which kingdom of our organisms are fungi most closely related to?
Ano kaya? That sounds very interesting.
Oh, so merong 5 kingdoms, merong 6 actually kingdoms of life. So we've chosen 4, pero ano dito yung pinakadikit sa fungi evolutionarily?
Yung mga diverge nila. Surprise, surprise!
The correct answer is animals. So ang animals, nanggaling sila from the branch of fungi.
Yes.
Okay, so to clarify lang, yung monkey analogy, di ba? So hindi tayo nanggaling sa fungus. Meron tayong ancestor na shinir, yun yung fungus and animals, sila yung may recent shared ancestor. Okay? So si Noble Newt pa rin ang in the lead with 14 straight correct answers.
Grabe, streak.
Oo. Grabe, streak. Sige, tignan natin kung matutuloy mo yung streak mo dito sa question 27. These sharks each need to keep swimming to stay alive, except what?
So if you saw one of our Instagram stories earlier this week, you'll see that one of the facts there was actually about this, that not all sharks need to keep swimming.
Oo, so you should like and subscribe to the My Museum Mind School and VGC Art Center pages para makita nyo rin yung mga ganyang trivia time to time.
Yes.
So the correct answer is the white-tipped reef shark. Okay, so kaya niya mabuhay kahit hindi siya lumalangoy. So what they do is they inhale and exhale water habang tulog sila. Okay, so sa iba kasi, kailangan nilang daanan yung tubig para dumaan sa gills nila to breathe. Pero siya, kaya niyang mag-inhale and mag-exhale. Okay. Ayan, si cute turtle umangat bigla to second place.
Yes, go you!
Yes, okay. Move tayo to question 28. Which of these animals causes the most human fatalities per year?
This would also come as a surprise to everyone what the answer would be. So ano kaya ang pinaka-nakakategi na hayop?
Tao din ba? Kalabaw? Butanding? Or lamok? Tama ba? Mosquito lamok? Ano yung langaw? Fly.
Lamok.
Ayun. Okay, so the correct answer is mosquitoes. So yes. Mosquitoes are by far the deadliest animal to humans, which cause an average of 1 million human deaths per year.
Grabe! Ang 1 million! Napakaliliit pero napaka-dangerous talaga ng mga lamok.
Oo, at ang surprising ay kung sino yung number 2 na nakapatay sa
second
humans.
Second is actually humans.
Oo, so mga tao rin po nakapatay ng karamihan ng ibang tao.
Either intentional or accidental homicide.
Oh, so sa mosquito, yung common causes of death are malaria, dengue, and the Zika virus. Okay, so let's move on to question number 29. What do we call a graphical illustration of interconnecting what eats what in an ecosystem?
Ano kaya ito?
Kumakain ba ang aso ng ano to? Chicken ba yan?
Hindi yan chicken, Aaron eh. I don't think
so. Oo, so merong way for ecologists na dinodrawing yan. So what do you call that diagram? So it's called a food web. Okay,
yes.
So interconnecting kasi siya, kaya food web. So pag sinabi lang nating a relationship, a direct relationship, so that's your food chain. So, yes. Pag nagdugtong-dugtong ka ng maraming food chain, that's your food web. Tapos, so, yung food pyramid...
Kaya nakita mo, di ba, ang daming organisms that are there, and then all the relationships that they have, whether they are consumed or they consume.
Oo. So, yung food pyramid naman is about energy, tapos yung food cycle is the transfer of nutrients in the ecosystem. Okay, so we have one last question for round three. Extirpation in ecology is the blank of a species.
Iron, ano nga ba example ng mga species na to?
Well, yung isa nating common, kilalang example siguro would be pandas.
Yes.
So ano bang meron sa panda? Bakit natin masasabing extirpated na sila?
Di ba yung mga pandas, they're all bred in captivity na? Wala nang nag-exist ngayon na wild pandas, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, so that could be considered a form of local extinction or extirpation. So since lahat ng pandas sa China are already not in the wild, so bred na sila in captivity, they're already considered extirpated in China. Okay, so yun yung ibig sabihin ng word na extirpation.
Extirpation, yes.
Okay, so at the end of round three, si Novel Newt pa rin ang ating in the lead. Okay. So, kanina we mentioned that our second and third prize winners will win season passes to Mind the School online season 2. Pero ano nga ba ang Mind the School, Abby?
Ayan. So, I'm glad you asked that question, Aaron. Because Mind the School online, just like all our other Baffy people, it's close to my heart. So, Mind School online is where learning does not only exist, but it can now flourish in two worlds. So, there's the physical and the virtual world. So given nga na we're still under lockdown and we can't really go outside and discover things in the physical world, we can do this by learning virtually. So Mind School Online is your online subscription to connected learning through K-12 aligned video lessons and resources. So we actually had our first season, which is about matter and the universe, and now we are on our second season, which is about biology or life and the environment. So of course we have our hosts, Mind Movers Aaron Espinosa and Abigail Napeña. So you can catch us there as well. Hindi lang dito sa mga Kahoot Games at sa mga live ng Mind Museum nyo kami makikita at mapapanood. So join us on our adventures at Mind School Online.
So I think we'll be playing a trailer of Mind School season 2. So here you can see what you will learn on season 2 of Living Things and the Environment.
Welcome back to Mind School Online.
I'm Mind Mover Abby.
And I'm Mind Mover Aaron. We are the resident biologists of the Mind Museum. We'll be your companions in this season's nature adventures about living things and the environment.
In this season, we'll discover what makes something alive, what forms life takes, and what lets organisms thrive. Tutukasin natin ang sagot sa mga tanong na, how many forms of life are there? How do our bodies work? And how are living things connected to the world? Pag-uusapan din natin how we could better take care of ourselves and the earth we share with many other organisms.
By the art cart, we'll get up close and personal with budding Filipino artists who create art inspired by nature. We'll hear their stories and peek into their creative processes. Together, let's discover the marvels and ingenuity of these local artists and be inspired by Filipino talent. Kilalanin natin ang galing Pinoy.
Let us nurture your minds as we connect the life sciences
and art inspired by nature. Kita-kits tayo dito sa Mind School Online.
Where learning leads to a better normal.
Okay, so that was Mind School Online Season 2, Living Things and the Environment. So don't forget to sign up at mindschoolph.org/subscribe to watch episodes 1 of Season 1 and 2 for free. And then you can also see there are plan offers for both season passes and year passes. So Mind School Online is only one half of the Mind School project. So baka nakita nyo na siya on TV. So that's also part of the Mind School program. So Mind School TV is a family educational show about how things are connected across the sciences and the arts. So catch Season 1 with Mind Movers Peter and Mikey on Colors Channel 202 HD and Channel 60 SD on Saturdays at 9 a.m. You can also join them at 1PH Channel 1 on Sundays at 10 a.m. They are also streaming for free on Signal Play and the Mind is Cool YouTube channel. So here we'll be showing you a trailer of Mind is Cool.
What in the world is going on?
Something has happened that has changed the way we live, work, play, and even learn. The whole world at the same time.
Tama, Fisher. A small thing, napakaliit, has caused the world to turn upside down. It's almost invisible, like these microorganisms.
Ang programang ito ay nagsimula dahil sa pandemic para sabay-sabay tayong lahat malinawan tungkol sa connection ng maraming mga bagay sa ating buhay.
All right. So welcome back. So I hope you enjoyed the trailers that we've shown you, and we hope that you will watch us on Mind is Cool Online and Mind School TV. Dami niyong matututunan, guys. We promise you that.
So, oh.
Bilis ng oras. And to bring us home, there is no place like home. Let's start our questions for our final round.
Okay, so these questions will be about endemic Philippine plants and animals.
So according to a 15-year study, this island contains the greatest concentration of unique mammal species. So alin kaya dito sa mga islands na to ang may pinakamarami mammal species sa Pilipinas?
Oo, so kapag sa school, lagi natin naririnig yung kay Darwin, eh, di ba? Yung Galapagos Islands. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, nasan yung sobrang daming mammal species?
So the answer is Luzon.
Oh, so we already found a very large number of unique rats. Actually, cloud rats ang pinakamaraming nakita in the Philippines. So just according to the latest study, meron sila nakitang 9 kinds of cloud rats in the Sierra Madre mountain range.
Which is part of it.
So nandito sa Luzon. Kala nyo lang silang hanapin. Baka mamaya yung nakita niyong hayop nung isang araw dyan sa kalsada, hindi pala known to science, di ba?
Yes, discover and experience. Pero syempre, stay indoors pa rin tayo to keep safe. Siguro later on na natin, pwede ma-discover ang mga animals na to. And of course, we have to take care of them.
Okay? So meron tayong question dito sa live chat asking why Luzon? So it's not clearly known, pero one explanation could be na since Luzon is an island, so, nung nag-emerge siya from under the ocean, merong biglang malaking bahanting space here sa area ng Pilipinas. So, pwedeng yung existing organisms noon flew or swam or walk papunta dito sa Luzon mainland. Tapos, dito sila nag-diversify. So, sobrang dami ng lupa dito. Okay? So, let's move to question 32.
So, what is the local name of the freshwater sardine species that live in Taal Lake? So this is actually a very interesting question. Oo, kasi very unique to. And you can find it in Taal Lake.
Oo, so halos, actually, nakakalungkot din na this animal is already endangered.
Yes,
tapos nangyari pa yung Taal eruptions natin. So we're not sure kung most likely umunti ulit yung number of
tawilis.
Tawilis. Okay, so that's what you call
your... The answer is tawilis.
Yes. Okay, so let's check our leaderboard. Noble Newt pa rin.
So Noble Newt is still in the lead.
Okay, question number 33.
So what is the current IUCN status of the popular ornamental plant Alocasia senderiana? So you, if you've heard about this or you've seen it, Alocasia is actually very popular nga as an ornamental plant, but it's actually under what IUCN status now?
Oh, so this is also called the Chris plant. Tapos kapag bumili kayo nito sa isang breeder na walang permit, it's illegal. Pwede kayong ikulong. Kasi they are already...
Yes. Critically endangered. So the correct answer is Alocasia senderiana is actually critically endangered na.
Oh, which is so, the most severe level, di ba, of concern.
Marami naman pong available na ornamental plants that you can still purchase. So let's take care and make sure that we don't lose our Alocasia senderiana. Okay?
Oh, so you can get other Alocasia. Wag lang si Alocasia senderiana.
It's very beautiful, but also it's critically endangered. So we should keep that all in mind.
Oh, oh. Sige, move to question 34.
34. There are many endemic species of the genus Platymantis in the Philippines. So what organism is Platymantis? Ano kaya? This is actually very interesting. And do you know, there are around 22 species that are endangered. And all of them actually undergo direct development. Meaning, wala na silang juvenile stage. Diretso adult na sila agad.
Okay, so marami tayong naloko sa ating platypus option. Answer is, they are frogs.
So yes, Platymantis is a well-represented frog species. So some records show na may 26 species. Others say it's 60 plus. So medyo depends pa sa, ano, sources to yung number of species ng Platymantis.
Oh, pero maraming klase ng ganitong frog in the Philippines.
It's just sad that they're also endangered.
Oh, yun nga lang, endangered na sila. Okay? Sige, our scoreboard, may iba lumipat sa top 5. Si Funny Condor na yung nasa 5th position. Okay, let's move to question number 35.
So, Philippine tarsiers are most famously found on which island? So, isa rin to sa mga animals na bata pa lang tayo, dapat alam na natin. At alam din natin kung saan natin sila mahahanap.
Oh, oh.
So, Aaron, pero, have you ever seen tarsier in real life?
Actually, I have. Dalawang beses na. So, una kami nagpunta dito sa island na to, pwede mo pa silang hawakan eh. Like, pwede mo pa silang ilagay on your head. Which is actually very stressful to them. So, siguro narinig nyo na na nagsisuicide ang mga tarsier due to stress. So, buti ngayon, what they do here, so yung correct answer is already shown sa Bohol. Ano na lang sila sa wild. So, naka-net off yung mga puno. So, kayo yung hahanap kung nasaan. Pero hindi nyo rin sila pwedeng lapitan or hawakan. So, which is nice, para hindi na sila namamatay.
So, Bohol is actually a beautiful island which also has Lobok River, Chocolate Hills, and many more natural attractions. So, tarsiers don't actually do well in captivity and they are considered to be one of the smallest leaping primate species.
Oo, at carnivore sila. Kumakain sila ng daga. Diba? And they are also found... Tsaka hindi lang sila found in Bohol, they are also found throughout the southern islands of the Philippines.
Yes.
Okay? Umahabol si Space Bobcat, ha? Nasa second place na siya.
Yes, Space Bobcat returns. Noble News still in the lead.
Okay, punta tayo sa question number 36.
This animal is often poached for its golden scales, which are used in traditional Eastern medicine. So sadly, this is such a beautiful animal, but it's poached to be used for medicine. So, alin kaya dito sa mga animals na to ang tamang sagot? So, we have balintong, tuko, kalaw, and binturo.
Sige, tingnan natin. Ayan. 3, 2, 1.
So, balintong. So, the answer is balintong. So, balintong is actually what you would know in English as pangolin. So, the balintong, they're actually considered to be the most poached and illegally trafficked non-human mammal. So, conservationists actually estimate that one of it is taken every 5 minutes. And it's really sad news to hear since they're such beautiful creatures and they're very important rin in our ecosystem and yet they are being used for illegal purposes. So, just a few facts then about the other animals here. So, you also know about the tuko, which is the gecko. Kalaw is actually a hornbill, also a very beautiful animal found here in the Philippines. And binturong is the Palawan bear cat.
Oh, so I think lahat din sila are in some level of trafficking, no? So, which is sad din. Pero yung pangolin talaga na, like, nag-umpisa tayo nating live stream kanina, 13 pangolins na yun nakuha for traditional medicine.
Grabe, imagine nyo yun. Every 5 minutes.
Oo. Ayan. Si cute turtle na ang in second place. Pinaghahabol-habulan nila yung ating AR book nating first place.
Okay, yes, let's wait for the AR book.
Yung status nila sa question 37.
The rafflesia is a huge flower that requires a host to survive and this makes it a blank. So ito na naman, isa na naman sa mga lessons natin about symbiosis. So mga relationships between species. So,
given that our species requires a host,
pero maganda siya. It's very beautiful. So the rafflesia is actually a parasite.
Oh, so hindi siya mabubuo. Kaya lagi siyang nakikita at the base of trees kasi nakakabit siya dun sa root system at shoot system ng puno para kumuha ng nutrients niya.
Alright.
Okay. Let's move to question number 38.
The endemic giant golden crowned flying fox primarily eats what kind of food?
Okay, so flying fox, pero paniki ba to or flying mama?
So pag in-invert mo yung ulo mo, pwede mo naman tignan kung ano siya. They're actually very huge. So nandito na si name nila na it's giant, and of course as the name itself, it's gigantic. So these golden crown flying foxes actually like eating fruits.
Oo, so hindi sila kumakain ng tao, so wag tayong matakot sa kanila. Prutas lang. So kung maalala niyo, so they also act as seed dispersal agent. So kapag kinain nila yung prutas, tapos they let it out at the other side, kung dumapo yun sa soil, sa magandang soil, eh di na-transfer na. So tutubo na yung bago mong halaman.
Yes, so these flying foxes are actually endemic on select islands. And they're primarily fungivorous. So they actually love figs, di ba? Ang cute ng fact na yun. So they eat figs.
Oo, ako nga hindi pa nakain ng fig, siya pala. Laging yung kinakain.
Gusto siya sila sa atin.
Oh, sige, let's move to question number 39.
Last two questions. So, pilandok, a local legend, is said to be this creature. Okay, so yung picture na naka-flash atin ay parang hindi siya masaya sa buhay niya.
parang may nakita ata siyang kakain sa kanya. Like, may buhaya! Alis na tayo.
And then yung feeling natin, given na ano, nakakatakot pa rin ng coronavirus. So.
Ayan, so ano si pilandok, Abby?
Pilandok is actually a mouse deer. Local legends natin other, but pilandok is actually an animal called the mouse deer.
Oh, yun yung nasa picture kanina, di ba? Isang klase ng mouse deer.
Yes, they're very cute.
Okay, so before our last question, ito ang ating standing na scores. Ready na ba kayo sa ating last question?
Yeah, oh my God, I can't believe you actually reached.
Okay, so let's move to our last question. So hindi nyo makikita yung scores nyo after this, pero look at the order now. Tignan natin kung pasok pa rin kayo sa top 5. So our last question, question number 40.
The katala is known for its white feathers and red bottoms. What kind of bird is the katala?
It's this kind of bird. Itong nasa picture. Pero anong tawag sa bird na ito? It's a big bird. Hindi, ewan ko.
Small
bird? Ano bang mo dyan
sa fascinating birds in the selection, but what exactly is a katala?
Ayan, so it's
katala is a cockatoo.
Ayan, so dyan na nagtatapos ang ating fourth round at dyan na rin nagtatapos ang ating Mind at Home online Kahoot quiz game for this afternoon. So
okay,
before
so
natin ipakita ang ating scoreboard, so okay, so before we show you ang ating scoreboard, let's give a short rundown kung ano yung prizes niyong makukuha. For the fifth and fourth places, you will get the Mind Museum designed face masks in adult and kid sizes. So you can see them there on the live stream. Okay, so our third and second placers will get season passes to Mind School Online Season 2, Living Things and the Environment. And then for the first place, you will get a What is Nature? Everything is Augmented Reality book made by the Mind Museum. Okay, so baka nakita nyo na sa Kahoot app kung ano yung standing nyo. So dito sa live stream, bibitinin muna kayo namin sandali kasi we have to explain one thing. So just wait, there's more. Don't miss our birthday promo extended until April 30 only. Enjoy all three Science Wonder Kits, What is Nature? Everything is AR book, The Earth Below and The Sky Above for only 3,000 pesos. So you get a saving of 650 pesos.
Malaking savings na rin ng 650 pesos, considering grabe ang gaganda ng kits natin. AR book natin. But if you win this, you're actually if you win first place, you're actually going to win an AR book. So that sounds so exciting. So you can visit us at www.mindschoolph.org/promos for more details on these items and if you wish to avail of our products. So your purchase, as we said earlier, actually supports our foundation's bigger mission of championing science and art learning for a better world. And we get to bring this education or these educational things to kids and students who do not have access to online learning.
Okay, so ipresenta na natin kung sino ang ating top 5 winners for our online out quiz game. In third place, si Space Bobcat. In second place, si Cute Turtle. And in first place, si Noble Newt. Congratulations! Ayan, so kita na rin natin si... Ay, nawala.
I play Piranha and si Focus Shark. Ay, Shark ba?
Okay, so tingnan lang namin kung sino yung fourth and second place. Fourth and fifth place natin. Okay, so congrats, Noble Newt. You got What is Nature? Everything is Augmented Reality book. Si Cute Turtle and si Space Bobcat got season passes to Mind School Online Season 2.
Congratulations!
Okay, so we'll just load up kung sino ang ating fourth and fifth placer. So remember, for those na nanalo ng prizes, please sign up at bit.ly/TMMquiz, capital TMMQUIZ, to make sure na makukuha ninyo ang inyong prizes na napalanunan this afternoon.
Yes, don't forget to register.
Okay, so ang ating fourth place ay si Lively Piranha. And then ang fifth place ay si Focused Shark.
Yes.
Okay, so congrats ng The Mind Museum face mask in both kids and adult sizes.
Hindi na ako mapakanta ng Baby Shark kanina kasi Focused Shark yung
payad. Oo. Ayan, so maraming salamat for joining us at our this afternoon's Earth Day Mind at Home online quiz game. Don't forget to join us tomorrow at 4 o'clock p.m. Manila time for Art Mart Online Art for the Planet, and on Saturday, April 24, 2 to 4 p.m. for our Better World Cafe on the Lockdown Lifestyle. How our digital lives make an how our digital lives have an environmental impact. So visit mindschool.ph.org/promos for more details about those programs.
Ayan. Thank you so much, guys, for joining us today. I hope that you learned a lot and that you enjoyed as much as we did. So, again, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Mind School, and follow us at the Mind Museum at Mind School PH, BGC Art Center in Facebook, and in Instagram. So, everyone, stay safe and stay curious.
Yeah, so don't forget to subscribe to the Mind School YouTube channel kung saan nyo napanood tong ating live stream this afternoon para mapanood nyo din ang ating Art Mart Online tomorrow and the Better World Cafe on Saturday. So maraming salamat for joining us this afternoon at stay tuned to the Mind School Facebook page for more updates kung kailan kami ulit magkakaroon ng online Kahoot quiz game.
Yes.
So this has been Mind Mover Aaron.
And this is Mind Mover Abby.
Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Stay safe. See you tomorrow. Bye.
What if you and I had a dream school? Ano kaya yon? Would it have dinosaurs like experiments? Little things that become I'm What if you and I had a dream school?